Fruitman here, and I'm going to do something I have not done for quite a bit of time. I'm bored. I just got myself a Ryzen 3600X off Hardware Swap. Paid 25 bucks for it. It has two broken pins. I doubt you can see them, but they're on the corners of each. There's two. There's one on this corner, one on this corner. So I'm going to go ahead and attempt to repair it and see how it goes. The first thing you guys need is you need a donor. I've got this, I don't know what the heck it is, 2200G, that is my donor. I've got this, and I've got an old FX, I don't know what this is, an FX chip, that I use both of these for donors. The reason I like to use both of these is because the pins are different. This is taller, actually, the old Athlon series. They're taller than the Ryzen series, and the cool thing is if you have damaged pins in like the middle or, you know, a part that's really difficult to get to, you use these taller ones and you drop them in easier. So it's pretty convenient to have them. So since I haven't done this in a while, I'm actually going to take this one. It's a botched repair. I didn't pay much for this thing. Botched repair. I'm going to take some corner pins off and I'm going to try to put them back on without whacking three or four pins off in the process. So I will be right back in a few minutes, hopefully with a success story. So I don't know if you can see, but I popped off this one right here and this one right here. So now what you want to do is you want to take some flux. You just want to put a little bit on here. I mean, honestly, it doesn't really matter what you put on. I'm trying to do it with one hand, so it's going to be a mess. You want to wait until everything dries, because you don't. The worst thing you could do in a pin repair, and I've done it more times than I can count, is whack more pins off and cause more damage while you're doing it. So you want to wait until everything is cool. So then, basically, all you do is you grab one of these pins with your tweezers, and you need to get a good set of tweezers, right? And you kind of just, you kind of tilt it. And basically, you just drop it on. You know, you have the heat gun to it, and once you see there's some flow on the solder, drop it on, you let it go right away, and you hope it doesn't move. It's really that simple. I'm sure you'll mess up, but like I said, I'm just going to practice real quick. Do one practice. If I get it good, I will move on to the real GPU. So here we go. So here's the first attempt. Right here. It came out okay. So the funny thing is, for these end pins, you get a lot of leeway. They just have to have some of it connect to the main part. And you have to be able to just bend them back into place. So, I'll probably do one more, because that's rusty. Would I recommend keeping that one? Probably not. Problem with ones like that, if they bend the wrong way, and quickly end up like this one right here, which if you can see, this is the one that I messed up and killed this thing. It hit the pad. Now once in a while you get lucky. I'll see if I can find the pad diagram and link it. Well, you can hit one that's useless. I had a 40 pin job once that I repaired, and I whacked one pad off, and it was one that didn't matter. We'll try one more time and I'll come back to it. All right guys, so we've got the 3600 right here. I have one pop pin there, one there. This is probably about the easiest you'll ever get in terms of CPU repair. I've had ones in the middle, I've had ones on the inside. It's fun, and I'll go over those later. But here we go. I'll let you know how it goes. All right, guys, it's done. I'll tell you what. Being able to brace my arm on a desk like I showed you before made a huge difference compared to normal. This mat actually really helped too. So this one, I don't know if you can see it. Focus is kind of tough. That one went perfectly. I use these kind of tweezers, so I'm able to lock them in. And once I see the solder melt, I actually have some solder on this thing that I'll test the temperature to make sure it's what I want. And that's a pretty good guide. So anyway, once the solder melts, you put it on, you leave it in place, and then you let go, or you pull the heat gun away right away so that it closes up, and you slowly let it go and pull it out and pull your tweezers out so that you don't knock any other pins. That's the name of the game, is not knocking any other pins. Now this one back here, I got a little bit off the pad, but I think because it's at the end, it should be fine. So I'm gonna call this one quote unquote fixed. Now I need to go get a motherboard to see if it works. And once I can confirm it works, we're good to go. Well, I went to this build. I'm gonna make another video about this build soon. It's an open air build that I use as a gaming PC in my other room. The GPU is currently missing because I'm sourcing out another 4090. So for now, I just figured I'd pop out the 5900X that I repaired on here and to see if the 3600X works. So we're gonna turn it on. And here it goes, it boots. Everything works. All right, guys, successful repair. I just gotta go source out a motherboard. So I just wanted to go over one more thing that I would recommend, a few things I'd recommend for beginners. Like I've said before, to summarize it up, one, I would go get yourself some dead CPUs to test off of. Two, I would practice, practice, practice. Take one of these, do it 5 or 6 times to get the hang of it. I would brace your arms, both arms. You need a good heat gun. I'd get something like this. This is the I'll link the site where I got it from. It's a great one. Or you could even get something cheap from Google or from Amazon, which I'll link to. I have one of those right over there, which I used for quite a bit until I upgraded this one when I got into GPU repairs. That one over there is kind of good for just CPUs. It doesn't get hot enough for GPUs, as this one gets way hotter. So yeah, and then another thing, this is kind of funny, but another thing I would not recommend doing, you think this is silly, but I would not recommend the following. I would not recommend putting your fixed CPU, which is this one, getting it confused with your donors, because then you have something like this where Croupman had a fixed CPU, popped it out of his computer because he didn't need it at the time, and he took 15 pins off and took a working CPU into a non-working one. And because this is only a 3100, I really don't think it's worth the time to put the pins back on. So yeah, please don't do that. Make it really, really obvious which ones your donors are. I'm gonna probably remove some of these in the middle to show that this is a test one. Obviously, you can tell that these two are donors. Yeah, and then like I said before, you really, really want to avoid this. You get this, it's dead. Your repair is over. So you want to. You need flux. Flux is key. I'll link this down below as well. You need flux. You're gonna use. I don't really use it to take the pins off, but if if you are nervous, certainly can use it to take them off and use them to put it back on. So yeah, those are just the basics. It's really honestly not that hard. I watched the Linus video and another guy's video. The only thing I would recommend not doing is using a stencil. They don't work. It's so hard. Yeah, and I wouldn't attempt anything more than what I did tonight for most. I think the most I've done was 41, but I was just crazy and kind of a nut job. This one had two, and it was pretty simple. So yeah, and one more thing, which I should have stated and I didn't. When you see the pins, when you see the solder flowing a little bit, that means pins are loose. So if your hand's like shaky or wobbly, and you see like the solder starting to flow, pull the gun away, move your hand back, and start over. Because I'll tell you what, the worst thing you could do is knock 3 pins off while trying to repair one. It's super disheartening. It's super frustrating. So yeah, don't do it. So slow and steady wins the race on this. I hope you enjoyed the video. Hoped it helped. I mean, even if you're going to attempt it, I don't know if it's necessarily worth doing as much now, since the market is not what it used to be. But I've got 3 Ryzen PCs that all 4 actually, And all of them use repaired ones. I've repaired a 5950X, a 5900X, a 5600X, and a 2700X, amongst others. So, and hopefully this add this 3700X to the pile. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. Please like and subscribe. Croupman out.